Good evening, everyone. On behalf of the Ornato and Thong families, I would like to welcome you to Brian and Vicky's wedding day. I don't think any amount of planning could prepare anyone for how special this moment truly is. Vicky, you look absolutely beautiful. And Brian, you are a handsome stud. I'm not sure if you had a chance to, but you should look around. And you'll see that every single person here is gathered for one single purpose, and that's to witness the marital union of two people that we love so dearly. And even though it's easy to say, oh yeah, we all knew they were gonna get married, it's really important that we recognize that this is something new and completely amazing. Marriage, it's more than just that next step. Today, you're gonna make a lifelong promise, a vow, to love and cherish each other for the rest of your lives. And something like that cannot, nor should not, be taken lightly. In this most important chapter in your relationship, remember one thing: trust in your love. That's it, trust in your love. Your love is what kept you together all these years, and your love will act as the foundation of strength that you'll need for a successful marriage. Now, I'm no expert on this, but I have been married to your sister and your sister-in-law, the same person, for what will be 14 years. And I'd like to share something that I have learned about marriage as I too move through this lifelong journey with my wife. So what I've come to find out is this: love, it's not perfect. Love is not perfect. After all, if you think about it, we're each individuals with faults and imperfections. The key is to accept and embrace those differences and understand that it's your individual imperfections that actually make you perfect for each other. You are complements to each other. You're two different pieces of a puzzle that fit perfectly together. Throughout your marriage, there will be peaks and valleys, and in those challenging times, when doubt starts to creep in, just go back to trusting in your love. Trust in your love. You guys should keep things fresh and new. Love is delicate, and it requires prioritizing your relationship to have a healthy marriage. Think about it. You're around the same person every day. Your days get filled with unchanging routines, and then throw in a busy work life along with your 7 or 8 kids. And it's no wonder that so many couples forget to do just the little things to remain in love. So that's the challenge, and it's one that you're gonna succeed on. The challenge is not to become complacent. Don't get so comfortable that saying I love you no longer has meaning. When you say I love you, it should mean just as much as when you first said those words to each other. No amount of time should lessen that feeling. With each I love you, you're saying that I can't live without you in my life. You're saying that if this is the last breath I take, I want you to know that you have completed my life. When I say I love you, I give you my heart, my soul, my everything forever. Those three words are my vow, my promise to cherish you all the days of my life. That's what being in love is all about, and that's what marriage is all about. I'm so happy for the two of you, and I wish you a marriage full of happiness and love forever. I love you guys. Congratulations. All right. So, you guys can all sit down. All right, at this point, we are going to move into the zhongdai with the red strings. So if I could call Bong Tun to please come up here, and I'll give you the microphone. There you go, and I'll get out.
Hello, everyone. The Ti Zhongdai is a Khmer wedding tradition in which family members tie red strings on both the bride and groom's wrists to offer their blessings. By tying the red strings on the couple, the family bestows their well wishes for the new couple and their life together. I want to start off by inviting the parents of the bride and groom to partake in this tradition, and I guess we will move over here.
Thank you.
Okay, at this time, we're going to move into the vows part of the ceremony, and Brian and Vicky have written their own heartfelt vows, and so we're going to have Vicky start things off.
Brian, we've never settled on what actually happened the day we met when our story began. I say you walked into the first Cambodian Culture Night dance practice and picked me as your dance partner. You say I was the only one left for you. Jokingly, I hope. Whether I'm right and you're wrong, or I'm not wrong and you're not right, or my memory's accurate and your memory's false, whichever one of these scenarios is true, there is one thing for certain. Almost 10 years ago, in Gervais Hall at UCSB, the universe knew we were meant to be together. Someone once said, I want to keep hanging out with you until one of us dies. I'm always making jokes about hanging out until we die or you outliving me, but there's an absolute truth in the fact that my life would be less full and bright without you. All of my days are more wonderful because you are a part of them. Our story may not be like the romantic comedies I make you watch with me, but it's my favorite love story. Thank you for always being so patient with me, and for always making sure my heart and my stomach are full. Thank you for choosing me even during the years when I had not realized what everyone who knew us, including you, realized, that we are our best selves when we are together. I wanted to try my best not to sound so cliche in my vows to you, but here are a few cliches I wanted to say, now to prevent my heart from bursting. I feel so lucky to have you.
You're good. You're good. You're good.
You are my best friend. Thank you. I never thought I'd be so fortunate to find someone to love me as much as you do. Thank you for letting me say all of that without cringing, I guess. I was a really excited. I'm so happy to stand here today with all of our favorite people to celebrate our love. But what I'm most excited for is all of our coming years we'll have together in our marriage. I absolutely can't wait to sit on the couch watching TV with you after this. You and I are soup snakes. I love you and I really, really like you.
All right, man. It's your turn.
It's a tough act to follow. Plumpy, as you know, I wasn't really sure how to write vows, so I kind of split it up into two parts. So here's part one. I promise to always cook for you and make sure you have a full stomach and an even fuller heart. I promise to always be down to go to Disneyland whenever you ask me and eat all the new seasonal foods. I promise we will always escape out of an escape room on time, even if you have to cheat. I promise to always eat the rest of your food now that we don't have to worry about fitting into your wedding dress or me into this suit. I promise to always make a Seven Leaves run whenever you're in the mood for matcha and aloe vera. I promise to always kiss you goodnight and say I love you before bed, even though you go to sleep when the sun's still out. I promise to be the ear you need when you deal with crazy parents and kids at work. I promise to give you attention when we're sitting on the couch doing nothing and just hanging out on our phones. I promise to always make mukbang videos where we record ourselves eating food, even though I don't like recording myself. I promise to love and care for Penny as if she's our own daughter. There's a bunch of other stuff that I wanted to include, but we'd be here for a couple hours, so I cut it out. But here's part two. So here we are today in the beautiful city of Santa Barbara, California, the city where we met. 10 years ago, I was just the guy who had a crush on a girl who didn't like me. And I had to do the hardest thing that I've ever had to do, which was to just wait. Obviously, well, maybe not so obvious to you, I tried to flirt with you. I asked you to teach me how to crochet. I wasn't really interested in learning how to crochet, but I thought it would make me look cool if you saw me crocheting for some reason. I don't know. Turns out it was actually pretty cool to learn how to crochet. I was able to crochet a scarf for my mom. I think she threw it away, but that's okay. And when we were in KSA together, I would volunteer, always volunteer to pick you up with my car whenever we had club events. In my head, I try to rationalize that by saying, you know, we lived on the same street. It made sense that we would go together, but in reality, I really would have volunteered to pick you up even if you lived, I don't know, on the other side of the planet, if it meant I could spend more time with you. And for a really long time, that's all that I had. Little moments with a girl that saw me more as a friend. And I think at one point you started calling me your big sister, which is kind of weird, but we're past that now, so we're good. Some people told me I was crazy to wait for a girl that put me in the friend zone for so long. But every time I doubted what I was doing, there was something in the back of my mind that kept me going. And I think that even then, I knew I was waiting for my wife. And I've always believed that we were one of those couples with a really long love story when people asked us how we met. I thought it would take a really long time, and then it's just perfect. And now here we are, and it's perfect. Santa Barbara is definitely one of the favorite places for me in the world, because that's where I met the love of my life. This is where I fell in love with you, and this is where we become one. I like you, and I love you. You and I are soup snakes.
All right, and with that, we will ask for the rings. You go first.
Okay.
Yeah. All right. Oh, you go first. I'm sorry. There you go.
Ryan, take this ring as a sign of my love and fidelity to you.
There you go.
Vicky, take this ring as a sign of my love and fidelity for you.
And with that, it gives me no greater honor than to pronounce you husband and wife. Brian, kiss your bride. Ladies and gentlemen, for the first time ever, please put your hands together and welcome Mr. and Mrs. Brian and Vicky Thong.